And again, what I'm trying to do is show you the easiest way to get started. So in the past videos, I've done a lot of talking and really haven't shown the different techniques you can use as an inventor to build products. So what I've wanted to do in this video is really kind of dumb it down to the simplest things that you can make and possibly sell online. And right now what we're going to do is we're going to make a simple set of coasters, as in drink coasters for your table, that have engraved racetracks in them and different logos and things like that, to show you that you can take a very simple concept and make a product out of it. Now, this may not interest you in terms of trying to start a business by selling coasters online, but keep in mind, there's plenty of videos online already about how to make things with Solidworks, 3D printers, and things like that. And again, what I'm trying to do is show you the easiest way to get started. And what I've done here is in Solidworks, I have a basic set of coasters, and I'm going to show you how we made them. It's really simple, and it's something that you can get started in to at least practice Solidworks. So let's get started. Solidworks is based on a really simple principle. It's called parasolids or parametrics. And parametrics basically use surfaces to draw sketches on, just like you would draw a sketch on a piece of paper or in a program. You simply make lines and dimension them, and I'm going to show you that here. So right now I have a box drawn, and each side, it's a square, each side is 700 millimeters in length. And that's going to be the foundation of what we're going to build, basically the sheet of wood that we're going to cut everything from. So I've made my box, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to what is called extrude that box. I'm going to give it a thickness and watch what happens. Now, as you can see, we have a box that has become basically a sheet of wood. And this is going to be the foundation, like I said, for our coasters that we're going to be making on our CNC router after we're done designing it. So we're going to take this sheet, the 700 millimeter sheet, and we're going to cut a square into it. And the way we did that, again, if we go here, you can see I've made a sketch, basically two squares with the sides cut out, as you can see there. The little slit is 25 millimeters. We have a set of, I guess you could call them C-shaped boxes that are going to be the channels, and we're going to simply go, and we're going to go to a feature, and we're going to cut. Now, I've already done it, so what you'll see is, you'll see right here, we've done what is called an extruded cut, and this is the extrude here. So we're going through all. You can also make it blind. You can say, hey, I only want to go 1 millimeter deep, and if we did that, you would see that now it doesn't go all the way through. So you can see it on the other side, there's nothing through it. But if we go back, there it is again. And if we look at it on an angle, you can see we've gone down 1 millimeter. But what we want to do in this case is cut it all the way through. So we'll say through all, and we'll select that. And it simply cuts that box all the way through. Now, a couple other things we want to add to this. We're going to cut a slightly deeper cut here, because what we've created is tabs to hold the piece as we cut it. So we did that simply by, okay, so we select this corner and we simply drag it over to this corner, and you'll see that the rectangle now is right there. And then when we cut it out, got one here, and I also had one drawn down here, so it cut that deeper. Again, these are just little tabs that hold that square in place, and what we'll do is, after we're done making this, we'll cut it out. We'll use a little handsaw and then sand it, basically. It'll be really simple to remove it. Now we're going to add what are called fillets, and you can see here, this is a fillet. We can make these fillets basically any size. These are 2.4 millimeter, but we could make them, let's say, 10 millimeter, and you can see they're bigger. But 2.4 millimeter seem like a good size. 2.4 millimeter. We did some in here. And that's basically because the tool cannot cut square corners, so we have to have that fillet. It would put them in anyway when we cut, but it's a good idea to show them in your design. And then we just close that out. We now have those fillets, and we're gonna put a second set of fillets. So now we have all the fillets. There's our coaster. That's the coaster we're gonna be making. It sits on your table, and it's 125 millimeters by 125 millimeters square. But we have this big sheet. So what we wanna do is we're going to copy multiple versions of this onto the same sheet. And we do what's called a linear pattern. And right now, we now have 16. So in our linear pattern, we basically did four up, four across, and four down. And you can see the four here and the four here, and we spaced them by 150 millimeters. Simple enough to do. And we're just gonna finish off this sheet by simply filleting the corners. So now we have nice fillets in the corners. Right here is a fillet as an example, and that's that fillet there. And one last thing, we need some holes so that we can mount this sheet onto our CNC router. So there's some holes in the corner, and that's just a reference so that we know where to screw it in when we're doing some cutting. And we'll cut those holes first, and then we'll put screws in. That way we can cut all around the outside of this, and the four screw holes will hold everything in place as we're cutting. So that's it for now. And then what we're gonna do next is we're gonna show you how we're gonna add artwork to each of these squares, and we're gonna cut, then go on to the CNC router and cut it out. Again, this is a really simple product that we are building to show you that you can get started very easily at creating your own products. You can do it at home. It's simple to do. There's plenty of low-cost CNC routers. You can also do this on a laser cutter. We, for this process, like the CNC router a little bit better. It gives a cleaner edge. It does take a lot longer than a laser cutter, so that's something to think about. But laser cutters are good for cutting acrylic or MDF, which in this case, that's what this is. But you decide, depends on what you have available to you, what your budget is. And let's take a look at adding the logos and the racetracks to this design, and then we're gonna CNC route it and see how it turns out.